So we already have a form on which we have email, date of birth, qualification, nationality, photo, and the save button is in place. Now we shall do storing the data to the server. Now we shall demonstrate how this data can be taken to the server and stored there, including the file that is uploaded here. So let us see what we already have. We have this form, validations are all in place, and now what we have to do is we have to take this data to the server. So what we would first of all want is a small message like thing here, so that when the user clicks save and no photo is uploaded, then a message should appear here, please upload a photo. Or if he saves successfully, then a message should appear here, data saved. So this is one thing that we need here. We need a display here so that it conveys messages that are coming from the server. For this, we'll come and add. We shall now, this is the place where we can fit that label. This is the input button, and just after that we can put the label here. But how will that information come here? This is our controller, this one. We plan to send that information in a view bag. That view bag can be read there. So for example, if model is valid, we can write view bag dot status is equal to record saved. And else, if it is not valid, then we can write some error record, because that we need not show here, because validations will take care of that. So the point is that we are going to store message coming from the action method in a variable called status. We shall read that variable here and display the message. So how will we do? If string dot is null or empty, view bag dot status. If not, if it is not null or empty, then we can write a div here, and here we can write at the rate view bag dot status. You can always format it by adding suitable CSS classes here to give it in red color or whatever you want. That message will appear accordingly here. So this is our controller where we have added that message, and we can test it first. We can test that message first, whether it is appearing or not. So it will come in a moment, and we can write a at the rate a.com, date of birth can be chosen to be, let us say, something around 3, and then we can pick one of them and click save. So the message has appeared here, record saved. Now this is okay. We have an understanding that we can write the saving code here into database and then record will be saved. But before going there, one important thing is like how to check whether the file has been uploaded or not, so that data is not saved if no file has been selected by the user. This is your that editor template where we have that file upload button. We have to test at the server end whether this file appeared or not. Okay, here before going to that point, I would like to tell generally You will use HTML5 to detect at the client side whether this file is there or not. Those detections will better be done by HTML5, so that is one of the possibilities. Then HTML5 offers a certain advantages for that, because that is not a part of this course. We are demonstrating how to do this in the absence of HTML5, so that the file here can be tested at the server side whether it has appeared or not. Although that is not one of the recommended ways, because if a file has not been chosen and you simply want to tell that please select a file, it is often better to go for HTML5 to make sure that you check it before posting it to the server. MVC right now doesn't have any support for that, so you have to rely on third party things like HTML5, and of course the support available with HTML5 is server side, which we are going to implement right now. So here what we have done is, we have written type is file so that a file browser appears. Then name is file. Name is file means that the file data will be sent in a post variable called file. Just like form data in case of this nationality is being set in a post variable called nationality. In this radio button, the data is being sent in a variable called nationality. The data for this is going to be sent in a variable called file. But before a file can be posted, we have to do certain changes into our form. This will render a tag like this, form, and maybe one or two properties regarding method of posting and all. But when you have a file upload button inside this form, then the data will not go unless you set an attribute called enctype correctly on this form. Enctype is set to a multi-part upload. This tells the browser at the other end, the server at the other end, that the file is going to be sent in chunks, multi-parts. So it keeps its handles open so as to wait for the next chunk like that. So unless you set enctype attribute here, no data can be sent to the server. This means, just like we were setting ID here in our template, just like we were setting these attributes like checked and ID, this one ID on date picker, similarly, we have to set an attribute on this form. That attribute has to be enctype having a variable having a value of multipart. So how do we do that? For that, we have to come and tweak around this begin form. This has 13 overloads, and let us see which one sets better. Looking at it, this one is the one that will work for us. Action name, we know the action to which it is going. Controller name, we know the controller to which it is going. Form method is post, and object HTML attributes. So we can set that attribute here on that form, enctype and all. That will be set as an anonymous object or as a dynamic. So let us do that. So first is action name, then controller name. So let us write the action name. Action name is index. And the controller name is home. And form method is form method dot post. Now here we have to set the attributes. So what is the attribute? Enc type. So enctype will be multi-part by form data. This is used to inform the server that the data is going to come in chunks, different parts, and therefore we must mention it here. If we don't mention it, things won't work. Okay. This one now is fine for sending data from here to the server. But there also we have to have a mechanism for receiving it. It can't be sent into TBL registration because there is no property for file here. So the way is, the file comes as an HTTP posted file base. It is this object that you have to use here, and its identifier has to be set equal to file, because here the name is file. Had it been X file, then we should have changed it to X file. So we are bringing it back because we have already done the code that way. This name must match this one. So here we can write, if null is equal to file, then we can set a message called viewBag dot status file required, and then we can put else and get qualification data, and then things will work. Okay, if no file is uploaded, then in our view bag we are setting the status as file required. If file is there, then we do the remaining checks. If the model state is then valid, then we'll take the record to database, and otherwise we are going to fall through and we are going to pass back the view so that information can be seen by the user as to what went wrong. Let us now run it without uploading a file and let's see whether that message pops. Okay, we can begin typing the email here. support@hoventrainings.com. Date of birth can be taken as 3, qualification as BCA. We are not uploading anything here, so click save, and message pops up, file is required. So this part is working. And in case we browsed to some file, for example developers.xml, and then we click save, then it will say record is saved. So that data has been saved to the database. Let us now write the database saving code also. So here we are. We have to write the data here. First of all, we'll need to use that database and all. We'll do it right now. So we can open the context here. ctxt.tblregistrations.addTBR, that is this that is coming from the client side, that is being stored here, and then click save changes. So this should actually be sufficient to store the information into our server. Let us test it this much. a@a.com, date of birth 3, qualification mtech, and photo we can browse to something, and then click on save. Let us wait for it. Record saved. Now let us verify whether a@a.com has come into our database or not. Come to Database Explorer, Database Connections, Tables, TBL Registration, Show Table Data. And this is the record that has been saved recently. So this means we are able to save data. Now what is left? One thing we haven't yet saved this file. So how can we save it? Let us create a folder. Let us suppose for simplicity that we are going to save it under content. How do we do that? We can write here, in case it works fine, this code works fine, then we can come here, file is your identifier coming from there, dot, then you can make some tests here also, file name, if the file name extension is not valid, or its size is too much, or it is its content type is not what you want. Then instead of saving it here, you can just write a small bit of code here. Let us say you can write that code here itself. to tell the user that the file is not allowed instead of saving. That plus minus in logic you can do yourself. So, but we are now going to demonstrate how to actually save it. So this file object has sufficient number of properties to allow you to make pre-checks. Then there is an interesting function called save as simple as that. So where we want to save, we can write server dot map path, and here we can write tilde by content, and we can give it any name. So this time I am giving it a name, let us say plus tbr dot id, maybe equal to whatever id is coming from there, so it will save it accordingly. So let us now verify running it that the file should actually be saved by this tbr dot id, and it will be saved without any extension. So we can now run it and see it. We can begin by adding email here. We'll write any@any.com. So just a dummy email, click 4, set the qualification, click on this. Let us say we want to upload this developers.xml. So click save, record is saved. Now let us see whether it has appeared under the content folder or not. Come to Solution Explorer. This is the content folder. We can refresh this one. If there is an option here, no option is here, so probably the option is here. We can refresh, and yes, a file 4 has appeared. You must tick mark this one, show all files, because this file is not a part of your project, so it won't be shown by the Visual Studio unless you say show all files. This is an option at the top, show all files. So 4 file is there. It is an XML file that we have actually uploaded. So this is how we have actually succeeded in completing this form, where we are picking data from the server. Through this whole exercise, we have seen how we went with annotations and how we created a form with all the possibilities, and how it is doing server-side validation, and how we are actually taking a file to the server. This closes this chapter. Next we shall see how to incorporate AJAX into it, so that this whole story is done via AJAX.